So let us start with, I'm starting with very primitive, because this type of lecture I deliver at place at people with to people who do not know anything about ECG even. And even when we started ECG, okay, our first interaction is something related with the heart. Okay. ECG is basically a status of the heart, we usually know. So we'll start with it. That when you say heart, dil, hriday, what is the first thing that comes into our mind, okay? And okay, so contrary to the prevailing poetic belief, heart is not a place of stay or worship, neither it is a commodity of exchange, nor it is an organ which meant to wish, say, or compute any logic. But this is a general notion we usually have about the heart. In fact, what the heart is? It is basically an organ that is located slightly to the left inside our chest cavity, okay, but mainly it is in the center, and it is the size of a closed fist, okay, and it is rhythmically propelling blood to the various parts of the body. And this last line is most important. It is the over a typical lifespan of 76 years, the heart beats nearly 2.8 billion times, nearly 3 billion times, and about 170 million liters of blood it will be pumping. So it's a huge, big, very big machine, in fact, and it is pumping continuously. It rests just slightly, otherwise it keeps on pumping. Can anyone tell when our heart stops? Hamara heart rukta kab hai? Huh? Kab rukta hai? Zinda aadmi ka bhi heart rukta hai. हाँ जी, नो नो नो, जब आदमी जिंदा होता तब भी बीच में हार्ट रुकता है, फिर वापस चालू हो जाता है. यस, व्हेन यू स्नीज एट द टाइम व्हाट हैपेंस, बिकॉज आवर एयर वे हैज टू बी क्लीन्ड, सो दैट्स व्हाई नेचर हैज इन्वेंटेड स्नीजिंग. नाउ हाउ इट कैन, सो व्हाट इट विल डज, what it will do, it will compress your lungs. When the lungs are being compressed, at the time if your heart is filled with blood, then what will happen? It's something like ek gubbara hai, bhara hua gubbara, agar aap usme compress karne ki koshish karenge to kya hoga? Phoot jayega, pure chances hai ki phoot jaye. So what the nature does, it first compresses the heart, pumps the complete blood out, and then it compresses the lungs, okay, so that the heart is not at all punctured, and then you sneeze out. So jab hum cheekte hain, momentarily hamara heart ek bar pehle rukta hai, pura compress ho jata hai, dono ventricles, dono auricle, unse blood nikal jata hai, aur uske baad mein lungs compress hote hain, aur uske baad hum log hamari sneeze aati hai. There is one thing, but in between the heart beats also the heart rests, and that is usually the isoelectric zone, that is the TP segment in which the heart stops. तो आपने देखा होगा, अगर मान लो अरिथमिया, सबसे जो हमें जो सबसे डिफिकल्ट अरिथमिया का पार्ट लगा है अब तक, मेरे पेशेंट्स बहुत सारे टीपी ओवरलैप के कारण से बाद में कॉलेप्स कर जाते हैं, वो यही है कि इफ देर इज नो गैप बिटवीन टी वेव एंड द पी वेव, नेक्स्ट पी वेव, देन वॉट विल हैपन, टी एंड पी विल बी ओवरलैप, द हार्ट विल नॉट गेट द रेस्ट. So after a while, the heart will be having fatigue and then it will lie. Anyway, but usually in our common practice, we usually say that the heart does not stop in its normal functioning at all. This is a heart, human heart. I think all of you must have seen it, so I'm simply skipping it. And cardiovascular system, I think all of you must have studied also. Okay, this is cardiovascular system. This is a normal ECG. I'm going a little faster than this. Okay. So this is a ECG wave, and this is how, after this T wave and P wave, U wave sometimes you may not see. So usually this segment is called a TP segment. We usually call it a TP segment, U waves. And anyone knows about U waves? Aap mein se koi? किसी को थोड़ी बहुत जानकारी हो तो बताएंगे, Interestingly, well, when William Einthoven, actually I have gone through some papers of William Einthoven, some even correspondence of William Einthoven. In one of the correspondence, a letter to some scientist, he has mentioned this thing, that how this ECG nomenclature he has given. He started with the U wave. He called it unknown, because its origin he was unable to identify. And then in the reverse order he gave, so ultimately he ended up with the P wave. So the waves become P, QRS, T and U. Okay. But this mystery was resolved in the year 2003 to 2007, when our friend Ritsema van Henk from Netherlands, he identified that the U wave is a result of the late repolarization of certain myocardial cells which are located in the deep apexes of the ventricles. His papers are available, you can download, they are available, and he has mentioned it something like that, that resolving 103 year old mystery. So U waves are no longer unknown waves, they are now known. But still, this segment is still called TP segment, in which the U waves are there. So this is where the heart rests for a while. So if T and P waves, when they will mix together, then certainly the heart will not be able to rest. So this is how the ECG signal is generated. This diagram you can download from internet, it is available. So SA node to AV node, and then bundle of His and then Purkinje fibers, you all know it very well. But it is, in fact, ECG signal is a summation of all the voltages which are appearing from different parts of the body, and then when they are summed up, then ultimately you get this our dear waveform of ECG, in which P, Q, R, S, T waves you usually mention. In fact, if all the components they are segregated, you will never be able to know that how this wave will ultimately look like. So this is one diagram you will not find in any of the books, just representation of what can affect an ECG signal. So basically our complete body, human body, is governed by our autonomic nervous system. If I look at the mobile phone, and if it starts vibrating or ringing, immediately my heartbeat goes up. Why? It may be from my boss. Okay, today is 30th of March. I have to be in my office, but I'm here. Okay, he may ask, where are you? There are so many bills pending, etc., etc. They have not been cleared. So he may fire me. 99% chances are there. So when I see that the mobile is vibrating, immediately my heartbeat may be going up. Okay, but when I look at it, it is from my child, my daughter, then what will happen? Oh, it's okay, normal. My heart will be again returning back to its normal. And when I see that it is from somebody unknown, oh, don't bother at all about, no need to even. So heart will return back to its normal heartbeat. Then what will happen? Suddenly you receive a bad news. You cannot do anything. You have gone into depression. Then your heartbeat will further slow down. So these all variations are continuously with you, and it is because of the autonomic nervous system. If those who are studying heart rate variability, they must be knowing it very well, that we have to have positive and negative heart rate variability, and positive heart rate variability is always better. Okay. Then you can see that autonomic nervous system, it controls the firing of the SA node. So it will decide the beat. At the same time, the autonomic nervous system, it affects the myocardial contractility also. What is myocardial contractility? Your heart never pumps, or rather never works at 100% capacity every time. Okay. Sometimes our body requires lesser blood, so it will pump less. Sometimes it will require more blood, so it will pump more. And in fact, the deep-seated M waves, the deep-seated M cells, which are responsible for U wave, they somehow control the myocardial contractility. They decide that now the cycle is over, so next cycle may be commenced, and so. So myocardial contractility is again a factor. So, in fact, because of this myocardial contractility, we decide the stroke volume, that in one stroke, how much blood the heart will be pumping. And then, when it is connected with the SA node, then together they form an ECG signal. So, SA node is responsible for your heart rate. And then, when the stroke volume and heart rate, they both get together, means volume multiplied by frequency, then you get the cardiac output, that in 1 minute, how much blood is being pumped, and then cardiac output is, it affects the vascular system and then BP, because the blood is being pumped, then vascular system is there, which is having so much of tubes. So what is happening, whatever is the pressure generated by the heart, it is going through various tubes. If the tubes are somewhat narrow, then what will happen? There will be back pressure developed. And so you see that the diastolic pressure, it will be enhancing. So as a result, what will happen? That action of cardiac output with the vascular system will be resulting in BP. And this BP is also further affecting the autonomic nervous system. And then renal system is also responsible in mixing with the cardiac output. Because the blood will be going into your kidneys. There will be filtering, the waste products and excess amount of water, it will be taken out, and then limited quantity of blood is returning back to your vascular system, and so and so. So renal system is also very, very important. It will also be affecting the cardiac output. If renal system fails, then what will happen? There will be excess amount of blood, or either excess amount of blood mixed with water and other materials in your body, and so what will happen? The myocardial contractility will not be 100% every time. As a result, what will happen? The cardiac output will be affected, and so what will happen? That it will affect ultimately the vascular system, BP, etc. So this diagram is such that all the systems, they are in one loop. One will affect the other will affect the third, and so multiple times. But ultimately, everything will be making its effect on the ECG signal. Similarly, cardiac output will be responsible for the partial pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide also. So they are coming from the respiration system. Why I have made them independent? Because there are other factors also which may affect the renal system. There are many other factors which may be affecting your kidneys. Like, what can be? There may be some disease in the kidney. Because of that, your kidney may be affected. Then there may be some anxiety level. Anxiety certainly will be affecting the autonomic nervous system also, but at the same time, it will be affecting your renal system also. Adrenal system will be there, and so excess amount of urine you will be producing. Then respiration can also be affected by number of other parameters. Like you simply close your nose, your respiration system will be affected. Okay. So if you have not done it, you can do this experiment right now. Just measure your heartbeat for 15 seconds. Okay, write down on a piece of paper. Do it. Measure how much is your beats in 15 seconds. Multiplied by 4, so it will be heartbeats per minute. Done it, sir? Okay. Normally, it will be coming between 60 to 80 in this range, because you all are sitting. And our videographer, he also, gentleman is also interested, he is doing it. I am glad he will become a good ECG researcher subsequently. Okay. Now, do a simple experiment, very simple experiment. You do not require any external material for it. Okay. But if the experiment is successful, I will be booked under IPC 306 for instigating a suicide. Okay, so close your mouth and close your nostrils. Okay, for just 15 to 20 seconds. Please do it. 15 to 20 seconds. Closely shut your mouth and closely your... Madam, please do that. 15-20 seconds. Then enhance the time till you cannot bear it. Now you find out your pulse for 15 seconds again. Done? How many have got it decreased? Decreased. How many found it decreased? How many found it increased? How many found it stable? There won't be anyone who found it stable because it has to increase. Okay. Why? Why so? The fundamental question of any research is why. What happens when your partial pressure, actually in this case, the partial pressure of oxygen will not fall below even 1 degree, 1% even. Okay. But what happens? It gives you a feeling in the brain, autonomic nervous system, that you may choke, you may suffocate, you may asphyxiate. Then what will happen? Autonomic nervous system makes your heart to pump faster because out of anxiety, sheer anxiety. Okay. So what will happen? The heart will start pounding faster. And so what will happen? The circulation will increase. By increasing the circulation, what the body is trying to do, it is trying to give more oxygen to the cells. The body feels that, oh, tomorrow if the oxygen is not there, then what will happen? Give oxygen, whatever is available. De do yaar, de do. Okay. It is something like that in one bank. Two dacoits came and said, hands up, nobody will move. Okay. So cashier ne kya kiya? Sabko awaaz lagai. Bhai, jis jis ke withdrawal hai, sab paise le lo apne apne. Okay. So that if they, at all they are looting, at least they will not loot the bank, rather they will take from the customer. So the same way heart does it. Okay. It will keep on pumping so that all the cells, they will get the oxygen supply for them. And if by chance carbon dioxide level increases, okay, in the, your blood, then what will happen? Even then it is dangerous. So what will the heart will do? It will pump it faster. So when the carbon dioxide, this partial pressure of carbon dioxide increases, then what will happen? It will try that more and more blood should pass through your lungs. So that what will happen? The exchange will be more, and so what will happen? Carbon dioxide level will be reducing. So whenever you have a feeling of asphyxiation, heart will pump faster. Many people do not know the difference between electrocardiograph and electrocardiogram. Okay. In fact, electrocardiograph is a machine and electrocardiogram is the record which is obtained by from the machine. Okay. So, in fact, electrocardiogram gives only the static condition of the heart. Okay. Nowadays, we do have exercise, ECG and so many things, but usually in the supine position if the patient is lying. And at the time, if you take the electrocardiogram, it will simply give the static condition of the heart, and it should be, it should not be considered as a sign qua non for any ailment. Means it should not be an indication for a disease. Indication of any disease has to be from confirmed by an ECG independent test. Always. This I think all of you know it very well, so I'm skipping it. This 12 channel system I also am skipping. Okay, augmented limb leads, etc. Oh, this was something important. In fact, this is very good for the people who are developing the ECG system. Our standard ECG system is a 12 channel system. You all know it. But I recommend that we should record only 8 channels. Lead 1 and lead 2, you should record. Lead V1 to V6 you should record. So it in all it will be making 8 channels. Then lead 3, AVR, AVL, AVF you can simply derive from using these simple mathematical formula. It's perfect. Okay. So in fact there is no need of recording these 3. We have these 4 leads. We have done a large number of experiments and we have ultimately come to learn that diagnostically the derived leads and the recorded leads do not have any difference like this. Okay. So these are the standard locations. I think all of you are familiar with the noise also, noise in ECG also. Okay. But the biggest problem that we are facing in India is because of power frequency interference. And for the power frequency interference, neither you are responsible nor the person whose ECG is being recorded is responsible, but more or less it is responsibility of the place where the wires are being laid. Like most of the time, the wiring is like this. And many of the people, to save copper, what they do? They usually do not run the returned wire with every wire. They club them together and then they have a common returned wire. So as a result, what happens? There becomes loops. So when electrical signal is coming in loop, what will happen? What will it make? It will produce magnetic field. This magnetic field is sufficient to destroy the ECG signal that is being taken from your leads. Why? Because this magnetic field is pulsating. This pulsating magnetic field, when interacts with the ECG lead wires, what happens? It will produce some EMF in it, and that's why as a result you can see the 50 hertz lines in your ECG recording. Dekha hoga aapne, zyadatar logon ne. Okay. So that is the result. So always, if you are trying to develop or design a biomedical laboratory, make it certain that every wire, power wire, should have a return path with it. Okay. Then all the third pins, they should have a proper ground. And ground impedance should never be more than 10 ohms at all. If it is more than this, then what will happen? There will be a neutral shift. So try to avoid that. That are the basic fundamental things which are not even available in the ISI. Okay. And it is always better to have a, you should say, a transformer, or rather isolating transformer, whenever you are using these devices. Why? Why isolating transformer is required? As sir was telling, I am just giving the application of it. Second harmonic, third harmonic, second harmonic certainly will not be there, third harmonic will be there. But if you are having a three-phase isolating transformer, then the third harmonic is usually absorbed in the three-phase transformer, isolating transformer. So you will get very less interference when it is coming. Fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic are usually very, very less. So you can suppress the harmonic component in your ECG wave interference if you are taking care of two, three simple precautions when you are designing your laboratory. One is always have the returned wire. Second thing is that have an isolating transformer. And third, if possible, try to have a very good ground. So that way you can reduce the power frequency interference in the ECG signal. So that is also a very common thing. You know it very well. This gain filter characteristics, usually it is the preferred range in which we should record the ECG signal. Okay. So now this is an ECG. Isn't it? You all have been talking about, isn't it ECG signal? Yahi to output aata hai. Nahi. Isn't it? In fact, it is a long train. Only if you are graphically representing it, then it will be looking like this. So it's a healthy human being, human Indian lead to ECG. Okay, you can see a P wave, T wave, and somehow you can see a little bit of a U wave also, some reflection here, maybe here or somewhere. If you filter it, then only you will be able to come to know. In this, you have power frequency interference as well as there is some noise very clearly over there. But when you downsample it, sometimes even you lose the 50 hertz signal also. When you are downsampling, not at in a multiple of 50. So this type of examples are also good in teaching the signal processing. Now this is interesting. The ECG of, whose ECG it is? Can anyone tell? What is so special in this ECG? Yeah? Madam? Huh? Any guess? Infant, fetus, or old man, young, kiska hai? Anyone? Wildest possible guess. Haji? Nahi. Anyone? Okay, prize money is 500 rupees. Anyone? Any guess? Ji ma'am? No, sorry, you lost 500 rupees. Anyone else? I'm increasing 7850. Okay, prize money is 750 now. Anyone? No? Haji? Old? No. No. Before I become bankrupt, I should tell. This is ECG of a snake. Okay? Yeah. They also have heart. So why can't we have their ECG? Okay. That's why I'm saying you will not find certain things which are not in any book. You will find. Okay, this is why my lecture title is ECG Beyond the Books. We had one snake in my own house. Okay. So one day I was just thinking, then Professor Verma, H.K. Verma, my supervisor, Professor Vinod Kumar and Professor H.K. Verma both were there. So I asked Professor H.K. Verma, sir, can I take ECG of the snake? He was surprised, well, how will you take? Because snakes do not have any limbs where you will fit the electrodes. I said, sir, I have made the arrangement for that. So I took two silver wires. I wound one silver wire above the heart, another silver wire below the heart. Okay. And I made some insulation in such a manner that just a little bit of it is getting in contact with the skin of the snake. And then I pasted the silver silver chloride onto it so that it makes good contact. And then these two wires I connected to our BioPack machine, MP150. And then I found this beautiful signal. This gave a wonderful information. Number one, heart rate variability is very high in snakes. You can see that the RR interval is less, and more. Isn't it? Rather, we should say it is more, it is less, it is a little bit more, it is more. In this cycle, the snake was breathing. This is how I came to learn. When you breathe, the heart rate variability decreases. You can also do it. बहुत सिंपल तरीका है. अगर आपने सांस लंबी लंबी सांस लेते हैं तो हार्ट रेट वेरिएबिलिटी जिस पीरियड में आपने सांस इनहेल या इनहेल किया उस पीरियड में बढ़ती है और जब आप एक्सहेल करते हैं उस समय उस पीरियड में एलोंगेट हो जाती है. सेम थिंग हैपेंड विद इट. ओके, सेकंड थिंग, बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स पोजिशन वी यूजली डू नॉट गेट द आर वेव इन दिस केस. ओके, अदर वी गेट अ क्यूएस कॉम्प्लेक्स, large QS complex, and then we have an R prime wave. Okay, I tried to discuss this matter with many of my biologist friends, including Brian Fry, and another friend is no longer in this world. I think you must have heard this news about his death, Steve Irwin, from Australia, the crocodile hunter. He was basically a marine biologist, done a good amount of work on reptiles. So I was trying to get in touch with him for that purpose, but unfortunately he expired. Brian and I also tried a lot, but we were unable to successful. So we could not find out. Now I am planning to record more and more ECG with many other reptiles. So if you also have interest in reptiles, please do this. Okay? Record more. And there's a wonderful world. that their heart rate variability is far, far different than ours. And if somebody wants to take this PhD topic, that the comparative heart rate variability studies amongst mammals and reptiles. Look, as the temperature falls, what happens to our heart rate variability? Our heart starts pumping faster. But in mammals, when the temperature falls, the heart pumps lesser and lesser, the heartbeat becomes wider spaced, and so heartbeat decreases. So what will happen? They go reverse. Okay. Jaise temperature abhi hamara lagbhag 28 degree 29 degree kareeb chal raha hai, agar temperature 20 degree ho jayega to aapka heart tezi se pump karna shuru kar dega, blood circulation badh jayega. Lekin 20 degree hone par ek mammal ka heart jo hai wo kam pump karne lagta hai, and they start going in the hibernation. Okay, you reduce the temperature to let us say 10 degree centigrade, then what will happen? The heart rate reduces even further. Heart rate 1 ya 0.5 tak pahunch jati hai per minute snakes ke andar. Matlab 2 minute ke andar ek bar heart pump karta hai. Is level tak heart rate niche aa jati hai. They'll just like dead. Okay, but as the temperature goes up again, then again their heartbeat starts. And this is a technique based on that many Russians have tried the cryo techniques, jisme wo suddenly temperature down karke limbs ko freeze karne ki koshish karte hain. They say that they are going into hibernation. In reptiles, the another thing is, as the temperature increases, again the heartbeat goes low. Aur hamare sath bhi aisa hota hai, as the temperature goes up, our heartbeat also goes low. Okay. But in reptiles, we call it estivation. Jab temperature jada badh jata hai, to unka heartbeat aur kam ho jata hai. And ultimately, they again go in a docile state. So, but that is dangerous for them. But nature has created hibernation as a wonderful activity for the snakes to survive in the winters. So this is it. And second thing that is also more important, actually last wali beat, basically elongation hai. एक बीट का इनमें से एक बीट को हमने एलोंगेट किया, उसको 5 गुना बढ़ा दिया, तो ये वाली बीट आ गई. इसको हमने एक्सपोनेंट स्केल के ऊपर देख रहे हैं, नथिंग एल्स. देन दिस इज समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, दिस इज पी वेव. स्नेक्स हैव बोथ द ओरिकल्स पोजिशन इन सच ए मैनर दैट दे फेस ईच अदर, and one auricle's voltages cancel the other auricle's voltages. Okay, so the auricles, they start pumping something like that, one becomes active and after a delay the other becomes active. So the result, what will happen, you will see that the voltage increases, then there is a notch, we call it dichrotic notch, and then the other. So, human being के अंदर एक P wave इस तरीके से होगी, लेकिन reptile में इस तरीके से होगी. Okay. And nobody has written any paper on it so far. Even I have not written any paper so far. But if you wish so, you can simply get hold of a snake and record the ECG. You can analyze it and you can publish a wonderful paper. It will be published in many magazines. Don't worry. Okay. Clear? Now, this I think already a little bit Vinod Kumar Saab had told, and many other people will be telling. So I'm not going to tell about this. We have feature vectors. Then already many techniques have already been explained to you. Special velocity, earlier it used to be our own, you should say, there are only 2 papers available in this ECG domain on special velocity. One is by Zywitz, the other one is by our group. But again, now you can have it in our this. Vinod Kumar Saab has already told that they have included it, so I'm not going to tell much about it. So again, I'm skipping this. There are many ways in which you can identify the features, and this is basically a signal processing flow chart, and so on and so on. Now something interesting on the application of the ECG. Basically, so far in classically, in books you will find diagnosis of classical abnormalities like atrial and ventricular hypertrophy, ischemia, infarction, pericarditis, systemic diseases, etc., etc. But one thing very interesting I could find out was the electrolyte imbalance. When in your body there is electrolyte imbalance, then ECG gets affected very severely. In many of the diseases, I have identified this. And two of my patients, with the help of ECG, I could find out that they are drinking RO water. So there is a potassium deficiency in their body, sodium deficiency in their body. And so ultimately, we had to ask them to switch over to mineral RO, and then they became all right. So there are many aspects of ECG which you can identify. Okay? So if you are not taking enough amount of electrolytes, then what happens? That sometimes there may be electrolyte imbalance, and when electrolyte imbalance is there, there may be this fine balance. If potassium level goes low, we call it hypokalemia. If potassium level increases, we call it hyperkalemia. And how they are affecting and how we came to this aspect, I'll just explain. So actually I was working on venom, snake and scorpion venom. And then we came to learn a very interesting thing, that venom affects these 3, 4, 5 components very much. So when it is affecting your respiration system, when it is affecting your renal system, when it is affecting your autonomic nervous system, and when it is affecting your myocardial contractility, certainly it will be affecting your ECG signal. So that is how I started my work on ECG of venom affected, venom interacted victims. Okay. So we have recorded ECG of many venom interacted people, and in fact we started in 2000. A patient, he was brought to us 5th April 2000. He was stung by a scorpion. It was Buthus thamulus scorpion. In Kota, we usually call it Thokariya bichu or Kalikammo. And in fact, by that time, there was no survivor of this scorpion sting in Kota. Whomsoever it used to sting, he used to die ultimately. That was the status. So we suggested that Holter ECG should be taken. And when I did the Holter, at that time I came to learn that it was having electrolyte imbalance. Okay. It was in the year 2000. Now many medical publications are there which are indicating the scorpion sting, electrolyte imbalance, etc., etc. But at the time no papers were available. So later on, so in fact what has happened, that there was severe disturbances because of the sting in the electrolytic system of the patient. So we started with a standard treatment and the patient survived. I'll just give you the ECG of that particular patient. Yeah. So when the patient was brought to us, it already good amount of time was elapsed. Now here you will see something interesting. In fact, here, QRS complexes are there, but they are so fast that the machine at the time could not record it. And even you can see the T waves, they are so high or so tainted, okay, that the top you cannot see. They are so fast. Okay. So even the T wave was mimicking like a QRS complex over there. So when I looked at that ECG, immediately came to learn that it is because of severe electrolyte imbalance and rather it is hypokalemic, hyperkalemic case. Okay. So, I advised my friend who was giving treatment to that patient, and then we could bring down the potassium level somewhat, and this is the ECG after 36 hours. Now you can see that somewhat T waves are visible now in V2 if you concentrate over here. Okay. QRS complex still not so visible. We continued our treatment for a while. The patient was coming back to senses and he was returning back to normal. And this is after 7 days. Okay. Now you can see the ECG is almost normal now. Okay. So this is where we started working on our research project. Then, I did digital ECG on all my patients who were coming to us. So, heart rate usually in the case of hyperkalemic ECG, it is usually high, 104.9 in this case. Okay. And then, lead V1 usually has T wave somewhat down. You can see it is inverted. Okay. Lead V2 is also down. When lead V1 and V2 or any at least two leads have T wave inverted, it is a dangerous sign that the heart is suffering. If there is one lead inverted only, we consider it may be because of anxiety. But if more than two leads are inverting, it means the heart is under threat somewhat. And the enhanced heart rate was an indication of the hyperkalemia. And at the same time, when your T wave is notched, there is a angle being formed. T wave should be a little bit circular, but when it is having an angle at the top, it is an indication that there is some potassium deficiency. This is, you are not going to find in any of the books. या वो किसी किताब में नहीं मिलेगा. Okay. So this is a scorpion sting case. And this is usually you will see a normal ECG, but this is what you say in scorpion sting. So tachycardia will be there, TP segment will be reduced, and in severe cases there will be T wave impression, this inversion and ST segment depression also. And moreover, at the same time, the P wave also becomes flat. So, this is you will see. And this is another interesting issue is spider bite. You all know spiders, huh? There is one very dreaded spider in India. There is Loxosceles spider, छोटी सी होती है, violent spider कहते हैं उसको, बहुत छोटी है, मैं अभी तक उसको जिंदा नहीं पकड़ पाया, किसी spider को, cases बहुत आते हैं हमारे पास में, और सबसे बड़ी अजीब बात है उस केस में, it bites, at the time you will not feel anything, but slowly, what will happen, wherever it has bitten, that part will create necrosis or other cellulitis over there. Then the cellulitis increases. So we could not find out what is the reason. Then later on we found that it is doing a horrible thing. What it is? Certain components in that venom are there which are working as catalysts. Okay. They're basically enzymes. What do they do? They will use your own body's various components and then they will be converting them into venom or other the toxic components. So what will happen? The spread will become more and more. So as a result, what happens? Initially, it is a very small mark. It increases and then it starts increasing very fast. A few photographs I can even show to you of my cases. this spider bite, but it is lunch time, you will be have to skip your lunch, you will not be able to eat the lunch, okay, if you see these cases, they are so, means you should say, horrible, okay, so that's why I am not showing them up. So in this case also QTC interval increases, and then there is inversion in P wave becomes diminished, T wave also significant changes in there in lead 3, and then again V1 to V3 we usually have some problem, okay. Then we have the saw scale viper bite case. This is a very late case. So in this case the venom was affecting the heart directly, and as a result you can see that the waves there, V1 to even V4, they all are inverted. So interestingly, right side of the heart was somewhat affected. When I presented in the international conference in electrocardiology, all the doctors were watching like this, because they are usually accustomed to see the inversion of T wave in this zone, V4, V5, V6, because left ventricle is usually the most susceptible to our cholesterol and other things and this and this. Okay, so usually when there is a heart attack or something of that sort, it is usually the left ventricle that gets affected. Right ventricle, they usually don't, right ventricle gets affected when you are having usually some disease because of the higher altitude or oxygen deficiency or something of that sort. This was something interesting and something new for them, that lead V1 to V3 and V4, they are getting involved because of some disease. So, but in this case, it has happened so. So then another snake, Russell's viper's case, and interestingly, all these animals, they are endemic to India, okay, black scorpion, Loxosceles spider, saw scale viper, Russell's viper, they all are endemic to India, so you can also interact them anytime, okay, you don't have to take a visa and go to other country, they are available in our own country. So that's why all the ECG that I'm recording, which I'm showing to you, they have been taken from Indian patients of mine, okay, and we have recorded them, we analyzed their ECG and produced their results. Okay. You can also enhance this research by choosing it as a research topic, okay, and so the changes due to viper, maybe something of that sort, that QTC interval enhances, bradycardia is there. Then hypertrophy pattern is there. This is due to renal failure. If you look at a patient who is having renal failure, means kidneys are not functioning, then what will happen? The urine will, the patient will not be able to pass. Then what will happen? The volume in blood volume, or rather the liquid volume in the body, will keep on increasing. As a result, what will happen? The heart will have pressure. Pressure will enhance. The heart will not be able to collapse completely. When the heart is unable to collapse completely, then what happens? The heart starts ballooning, and that is called hypertrophy. So we usually have hypertrophy patterns when there are some renal failure cases. And in severe cases, we usually have T wave inversion and ST depression in viper bite cases. And this is very dear to us. This is cobra bite. Surviving a cobra bite is usually very, very challenging. So, cobra usually has some cardiotoxins. So, they directly affect the heart. You can see that there are ST segment depressions. Those who have studied ECG very clever, they can understand. Dekhiye, ST segment depression hai. Yahan bhi hai. Yahan par bhi hai. Yahan par bhi hai. So, not only the right ventricle, but the left ventricle is also involved in it. So, ST segment depression is there. So, ischemic conditions you can see over there. But mind it, they are all reversible. In cobra bite, we can get them reversed with due treatment. Okay. So, PR segment also gets reduced. ECG, kitne logon ne research kar rahe hain abhi? Kitne log kaam kar rahe hain ECG par? M.Tech mein, PhD mein? Koi nahi? पढ़ा सबने है? ना ना ना, नहीं ठीक से पढ़ा आप लोगों ने. गो लिटिल बिट डीप. जस्ट पासिंग द एग्जामिनेशन इज नॉट एट ऑल जस्टिस फॉर दिस टाइप ऑफ सब्जेक्ट. इट रिक्वायर्स अ डीप स्टडी. ओके, ट्राई टू रीड इट. व्हेन पीआर सेगमेंट गेट्स रिड्यूस्ड, व्हेन एसटी सेगमेंट गेट्स एलिवेटेड, व्हेन क्यूटीएसई इंटरवल गेट्स एनहांस्ड. ओके, व्हेन यू रीड इट देन यू विल कम टू लर्न द रियल फील ऑफ द बायोमेडिकल इंजीनियरिंग. ओके, and then we come on to the crate bite case. Interestingly, hyperkalemia ka case humne usme scorpion sting ke andar notice kiya tha. Yahan par crate bite mein symptoms aate hain hypokalemia ke. So potassium zyada hona bhi khatarnak hai, potassium kam hona bhi khatarnak hai. In this case, crate bite case mein ECG looks either the T wave will be bifid, means positive and negative, both the deflections will be there in the T wave, or there will be TU complex, T wave and U wave, they will be mixing together, or there will be separate U waves, but U waves will be there, and QT will be further enhanced, heart rate will be reduced, and in severe cases, the T wave will be inverted and ST segment will be depressed. So this type of patterns you will see often. So interestingly, for the first time we introduced to the world that ECG can be used in identification of the snake species or scorpion species also, which has bitten or stung the victim. Hame patient ke ko dekh karke uska ECG leke malum pad jata hai ki isko kis saanp ne kaata hai ya स्कॉर्पियन स्टिंग मारा है, जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ ईसीजी. सो नोवल यूज ऑफ ईसीजी, यू विल नॉट फाइंड इट एनी अदर बुक्स. बट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंगली, मोस्ट ऑफ द चेंजेस इन ईसीजी दे आर मिमिक्ड. द हार्ट इज सो रोबस्ट दैट इफ प्रॉपर ट्रीटमेंट इज गिवन, इट विल बी स्टार्ट जनरेटिंग द नॉर्मल ईसीजी अगेन. So we usually call it is a mimicking. We do not call that it is permanent damage or it is irreversible change, rather it is reversible. Now I'll tell you something very interesting. Kitna time ho gaya? Agar time hai to batata, nahi to band karte hain. Ded baj gaya? Ded ho gaya? 5 minutes more? Okay. I'll tell you something very interesting now, which even in Stanford, they are unable to do something. I said that you take my presentation, if you want to do something, you can do on it. Okay. It's an area for nanotech research. And this is, in fact, what is ECG? There's thousands or other millions of fibers, muscle fibers in the heart, which are producing the signals, and we are on the top, we are simply getting a accumulation of the signal. Okay, nothing much. It is something like that. Khub sari aapke paas mein LED hai, bahut sari LEDs hai, unke aage aapne do teen safed kagaj laga diye aur fir aap dekh rahe hain udhar se, to aapko sirf illumination dikhai de raha hai. Unme se aapko ye nahi malum padega kaun si wali LED zyada bright hai, kaun si wali LED kam bright hai. और उनमें से आप अगर एक दो को बंद भी कर देते हैं तो आपको मालूम पड़ेगा इल्यूमिनेशन कम हो गया, लेकिन यह नहीं मालूम पड़ेगा कि इनमें से नंबर 300 वाली एलईडी बंद हो गई है या नंबर 217 वाली एलईडी बंद हो गई है. ओके, द सेम थिंग इज हैपनिंग विद ईसीजी. इनफैक्ट वी ऑल आर ब्लाइंड एज फार ईसीजी इज कंसर्न. वी डोंट नो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इनसाइड द हार्ट. देयर आर मिलियंस ऑफ फाइबर्स विच आर जनरेटिंग पोटेंशियल एंड दे आर अलाउइंग अस टू रिसीव द EMF on the top, picking up at standard locations and trying to analyze it. It is something like that. Anyway, I cannot have no parallel example for that. Means we are so blind. Okay. So, one-to-one correlation you will never be able to make. So, in fact, it is something like that. there are so many Z functions. Because why Z functions? Because all the EMF which are being generated inside, they are in the range of minus 70 millivolt to around plus 20 millivolt. But when they reach on the surface, they are greatly attenuated and they are mixed with other signals also, and as a result, what will happen? We considered that there are some impedances because of the presence of various muscles, various other fat layers, etc., etc. So we let us call them the Z functions. So there are so many voltages, muscle 1, muscle 2, muscle 3, etc. There are so many voltages which when interact with the Z matrix or the impedance matrix, they ultimately result in V1 to V6 on our chest. This is what the, in fact, your ECG is. Okay. So, what we have done, I have simply tried to model it somewhat, and I have tried to find out that this model is simply a RC network type of thing. Ek potential aata hai, lekin humare ko ultimately milta, jo hai wo ek band pass characteristic or other low pass characteristic ke andar hume milta hai. So, based on that, we have divided, derived our model, and now I'll tell you something very interesting. So, ye uske baad mein humne uspe kafi experiment kiye, humne kafi models banaye, dekha how we can get the best possible. Aur uske baad maine ek 36 electrodes ka ek matrix bana karke heart ke upar is tarike se paste kiya. Okay, sare ke sare electrodes chest se liye hain, baki sare sare electrodes jo hai wo humne ground karke, matlab right leg grounded tha, left leg, left arm, right arm, in tino ko mila karke ek junction bana diya. So we can say that electrode ka jo hamara uska amplifier ka positive tha, we used to connect with this any node of this matrix, or negative we used to connect to that particular junction of left leg, left arm and right arm. Okay, and then we did a band limiting function also. So if I represent, let us say this matrix, I simply suggest like this, or ye iska highest point or ye iska lowest point agar maan lo hota hai, I am trying to represent in 3D how they will be looking like. Okay, so now just watch it closely how the potentials on the heart, on the chest, they will be varying. Just have a look at it. I have reduced this speed of this is how the voltages on the chest, they will be varying. Interestingly, when there is a P wave, there is somewhat synchronism. But if I play it again, you will be able to see that the right ventricle, wo pehle blue pad jata, right side wala part, okay, there is a dip, means right ventricle starts collapsing before the left ventricle. You can see this. Right side mein pehle collapse karta hai, uske baad mein left side mein. And then the T wave will be almost like this. So my simple theme is, agar isko 6x6 ke matrix ki jagah, agar isko enhance karte hain, और छोटे इलेक्ट्रोड्स बना करके, या छोटे हम लोग इलेक्ट्रोड बना करके साथ साथ में उसके एम्पलीफायर भी इंटीग्रेट करके और एक मैश बनाते हैं. लेट अस से 600x600 का हमने एक मैश बनाया, यहाँ पे प्लेस किया, ऑल दिस डाटा वी रिकॉर्डिंग, देन यू विल गेट अ पिक्चर, यू विल गेट अ मूवी. इट विल बी मच मोर क्लोजर टू द कार्डियक एक्टिविटी ऑफ द हार्ट देन द करंट ECG एट प्रेजेंट वी आर सीइंग. And then I would like to acknowledge all these people who so far have helped us in doing this research. and this is a crate, very dreaded snake, and this is one of my patients. When I brought her in the hospital, at that time she was like this, and at the time of discharge she was like this. So it is because of ECG we could treat them. Our patient survival rate has increased because of the ECG signal. Thank you very much.